Hello and welcome to my vlog number 5. Who am I? My name is Alexander Orlovsky. I am a full stack developer, freelancer out of Germany. Here you have my contact information, my email, my website, my Google app which you want to install or not. So what kind of services I do provide? Software development for my clients, creating automatic unit tests for my clients, doing requirements engineering for my clients, advising companies about software quality, helping other students and people who want to get into IT, get hired for the permanent positions. And other ways, I participate on hackathons, and when something interesting is a project, I can do it too. So that's it about me. And now I want to discuss and present my current progress of my game, SOE 2500. Let me first show you my new scene, which I have created last week. Yeah. And let's speak about the challenge. As you see, the soldiers are moving, which is great. Did I program anything for this? What do you think? No, I didn't program anything for doing this animation. Because in Unity 3D, it's kind of pretty easy. You just loop the animation, provide the timeline for which you want to loop the presentation, and that's it. Other things to mention are the assets. All assets which you see here are provided by the Unity Asset Store or available freely and legally on the internet. And it's kind of fun creating such scenes, and it gives an impression how Unity easy to use, because you don't need to have big programming skills to do such things. But anyway, let's continue. The next scene was done by me on this week. Today is 11/8/2020, and this was done by me this week. As you can see, what I'm having here in the room, it's a foundry room. I have lava going on, liquid high temperature metal. I have here hook with pot or bowl, which have lava in it. And the process are monitored by two operators, engineers. One is male, another is female. They're monitoring the process of melting of the metal. And you have here forgetting the English words. You have here this facilities to which providing the temperature. And then you have cooling devices, which happens here and here. And then you have pipes here and here. So I'm trying not to overdo such scenes, but it gives you an impression what's happening here. The big challenge was to create the hook and the bowl with lava. It was major concern of me, because in Unity 3D Asset Store it was not available, and it was kind of hard to find the proper props for such mix prop, creating such mix prop. But I did found it. It took me a while, 2 hours, things like that. But I did found it, and then it was pretty easy job to combine it into the prop which I needed. Yeah, it's kind of rough, I must say, but it give an impression what's happening here. So I have bowl of lava or cup of lava, and which is monitored by the two operators. And yeah, major things about Unity 3D. Unity 3D is interesting engine, because it when do you use long time support version, you need to try to use you always the newer version, because the newer version have less bugs, improve some improvements on UI side and some improvements on overall experience. Like if you have in previous, like it was in my case, I did had in one asset from the Unity 3D asset store, which I cannot use in my project. I tried many times, but I always get somehow blue screen. But when I updated Unity 3D, current Unity 3D version, then I experienced no bugs. So it was kind of wow. So quality improves, and try to use always a newer version of Unity 3D. And I, by that I mean Unity 3D long time support version. So don't mix this up with the better versions of Unity 3D, which actually can be used too. But I prefer to stay safe. I use only long time support versions of Unity 3D, and I have no problems with that. And I'm pretty happy about the workflow when I use Unity 3D. So each scene are developed separately and then integrated in one project. By this, I not only pretty efficient in the resources of my current hardware, which is not super new, but it's kind of pretty enough to me to do this job. And let me speak about what happens next. So next time, I hope it will be end of the week, I will present another two scenes, maybe more. And then I will start to work towards new UI for my game, because my game is a complex one. It would consist an AI, it would consist of things like launching satellites, like events, and would have kind of interesting story. It's a linear driven story, kind of remind me Command and Conquer game. And then when basically my outline is done, like major missions in my game, major technology tech tree which I need to create and develop. And funny thing, when I think about larger games like Civilization 6, I don't think that I will manage to have the UI or completeness of Civilization 6, but I would actually have some parts like encyclopedia of the technologies. I think this is a pretty good idea, but I'm not sure how to really write to insert or to combine with my game, but this will be actually one of the major stories of my game. So basically, that is it. Hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon, and stay tuned for more. I will try to push new stuff, but of course it's not my full-time project, it's my part-time project, but I'm pretty sure that I would have quicker iterations in the future. My rough estimate, pretty rough estimate, that next year, like I don't know, 2021, actually in the middle of the 2021, I would have kind of working prototype. And yeah, let's conclude with that hopeful news. And as I said earlier, feel free to comment on each of my videos. I try to stay neutral to the comments, but anyhow, if you have any questions related to Unity 3D programming, you can ask the question under the video. And thank you.